you want to get up and speak about something?
Yes.
Okay. And we're collecting with the, I forgot.
Have you been?
Good. Good. Hanging in there.
So
better than not.
Right.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, come on. Good morning.
Good morning.
Think that you're at the Super Bowl. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to St. Mark's United Methodist Church. It is February 11th. We have a number of announcements we're going to kind of go over. I'm going to start with Kathy Delvecchio. She has a kind of little explanation of what you see in front of you.
Morning.
Morning.
When you came in, I'm sure you noticed the table is different today. We have a big gray blanket dropped across the top of it, and it's folded up. It's actually a full-size blanket. During Lent every year, we participate in what is called Blanket Sunday. Church World Service is an organization made up of Christian denominations who help people in this country and around the world with very practical needs. People who have faced all kinds of disasters, from earthquakes, floods, food shortages, health problems, and they address these in different programs that they run. It was started right after World War II to address problems that were created by the war, and it has grown and grown, and now the United Methodist Church is one of the denominations that's part of it. In fact, the part that we have chosen is like it Sunday. We contribute sometime during Lent. We put together all the donations that people give and send it in, and for each $10 that we send, they purchase one of these blankets. And the blankets are very sturdy. They've stayed $10 as long as I know. Probably well worth it. They can be used as a blanket on a bed. They can be used as a shelter for someone who's out in the wind, has no shelter above them. They can actually put it above them to keep the wind and the rain off. And that's their blanket. It's a way of showing that they're not alone, that God loves them, and that we show that through people in a practical way of providing a blanket for them. And if you would like to donate, for the next 3 weeks we'll be having donations. There's a box, there are little envelopes. People can give as much or as little as they would like, and we put it all together. So you can check out the table there, and thank you.
Thank you, Kathy. I appreciate all your work with that also. Every year, we do give a number of blankets, which is a wonderful thing. Also, in the announcements, we just wanted to make sure that this Wednesday is Ash Wednesday. The year goes very fast. And we will not be having anything here at the church, but Covenant United Methodist Church has opened their church and their arms for us. If anybody would like to go down, it's straight down this road for 1 p.m. and 7 p.m. for communion in ashes. And the address is there. At this time, Carol, you have a couple announcements.
I got the opportunity to speak with Pastor Ken last evening, and he wants me to give a couple messages to you. One of the messages is that every Sunday, just so you know, he's been in prayer from 10 o'clock on to 11 o'clock for the congregation. And he listens to the music and so forth. So he's thinking of us, and I hope that we are also thinking of him. He wants you to know that Alpha will resume in early March. You'll hear more about that. And he said, and he wrote this out, "I would like to thank the congregation and children for their outpouring of love with phone calls, cards, and with especially the children's handwritten words and pictures." And he went on and on about that and how beautiful they were. "Linda and I thank you all. I hope to be back very soon. Love you all, Ken and Linda." So it's, you know, it's important. Your cards do mean something. Your phone calls do mean something. And he thanks all of us
for being there for him and for helping to keep our services going.
And we have our prayer list, and I actually would like to add two names. First of all, I'd like to add Sarah Kirk's name to the list for prayers. She was in Bryn Mawr Hospital for over a week, has pneumonia. She is now going to be recovering at Dunwoody earlier this week. So she would appreciate your prayers. And some of us, I don't want people to know, like, why wasn't she put on like a week ago? It was really under her guidance. She didn't want to be put on before now, but she's been having prayers of us that know her, and we've been extending the love of the family here for her. But she is now ready that she would love an outpouring of your prayers and kind words and thoughts for her as she recovers from the pneumonia. And also, I neglected to put it, but I know last week we talked it, and I still want to keep, and I don't know if you watched the news and how, I don't want to say beautiful, but touching the blue lights that the TVs were able to show from the helicopters for the Petransky family. And I do want to keep them in our prayers. They got a lot of healing, a lot of things to get through. So we'd like to keep them in our family. And for next week, I'm going to add them actually to prayers beyond our congregation, for just to keep them in your prayers, because they've got a long road, folks. I think we all kind of can realize that. So at this time, we'll charge to church service. Brandon, give me 30 seconds.